Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Amen. Give me the book of Proverbs chapter 8 and verse 1. Because we've been out here teaching for a little bit over an hour. And it's absolutely ridiculous and pitiful that the men are the ones that's supposed to be raising up in our communities and leading the people, leading the women, leading everybody to the right direction. But yet, we have situations where a brother and a sister will come up. We call both of them over and only the sister will come up.
Bring it out.
In our communities, the sisters are more willing to listen to God's laws and apply them than the men. That's sad. That's not how it was supposed to be. Read what you got.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 8 and verse 1. Doth not wisdom cry, and understanding put forth her voice?
So the Bible says, does not wisdom cry? Does not understanding utter her voice? You're hearing the Bible coming out. This is your healing. This is your healing from what you don't know. This is your healing from that pain that you got. Because everybody got that pain. You don't like the way you living. You don't like the living conditions that you are in, being the last one hired and the first one fired, having a failure and a record that keep you from getting a job. Read.
She standeth in the top of high places, by the way in the places of the past. That's what we're doing right now. We in the places, the top places. We right here on Roosevelt in California. Speaking to you men, first and foremost. Because when you get yourself right, the sisters are going to follow behind you.
That's right.
Because the only reason our sisters are out here dressing half naked is because they follow it because you like it. But it's unrighteous. It's not how we're supposed to be living. So men, you have to stand up, you black men.
Look.
You Hispanic men, you have to stand up and stand up for what's right, which is God's laws.
That's
read.
Right.
She cried at the gates, at the entry of the city, at the coming in at the doors, unto you, O men.
So listen to what the Bible says. It says, unto you, O men. There's a reason why the Bible is written in masculine form. Because first and foremost, it's to you men. You men got to rise up and keep the commandments. You men got to rise up. Stop hanging out in the park all day. Stop being idle and getting into the midst of all evils.
That's right.
Stand up for something that's going to mean something. That's going to make your community better. Stand up for God's laws. Read that again.
Unto you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of men.
It says, unto you, O men, I call. The Bible is written for you first and foremost, men.
That's right.
So that you can stand up and get your mind right. You can stand up and get your sisters right.
That's
you can
right.
Stand up and get your children right.
Look it out.
Read that again.
Unto you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of man.
The voice of this Bible is to you sons of men.
Right.
To you men. It's time for you to get up and get your mind right. Stop being docile. Stop being weak.
Right.
And yes, being weak is selling drugs to your people. That's being weak. Being weak is standing at a park all day smoking weed, drinking, getting drunk. That's being weak. You're not standing up for your people. You're destroying your neighborhoods. Today is the day you stand up for the Most High God and His laws.
That's right.
That's what we out here teaching. so that you can get your mind right, so that the killing and shooting of babies can stop in our communities. Read.
Unto you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of man. O ye simple, understand wisdom.
So it says, O ye simple. You simple are those that's not taking heed to the commandments of God. That's what it means to be simple, that you're not keeping God's laws. You don't have God's laws as a high regard in your life. Read.
And ye fools, be ye of an understanding heart.
So what we're trying to get you to see from the Holy Bible, that you got to be of an understanding heart. And to be of an understanding heart means you have to take heed to God's laws. Give me Ezekiel chapter 34 and verse 30. We out here for you, me and my brother. My brother here with the red and blue shirt. You got a moment? Read that in Ezekiel 34.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 34 and verse 30. Thus shall they know that I, the Lord their God, am with them, and that they, even the house of Israel, are my people, saith the Lord God.
So the Most High God said, you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are the Israelites, and you are his people.
That's right.
The blacks, Hispanic, and Native Americans, you are his people.
Hey,
and what does God say about his people? Read.
And ye, my flock, the flock of my pasture, are men.
So he says, the flock of my pasture are men. The Most High God is calling you men to stand up. Because it's only when you stand up and do what's right that the community is going to fall in line.
The community
is going to fall in order because you're upholding the commandments. If you stop seeking and searching after that half-naked sister, she will stop wearing them clothes that's showing her body. If you say, oh, hey, no, sister, put on a dress. Walk modestly. Stop showing your breast. Stop showing your camel toe.
Right.
Stop showing your butt cheeks. When you men rise up and you start looking for a righteous sister, our sisters are going to fall in line. They're going to stop showing their behind. They're going to start living uprightly because they following after you men.
That's
whether you know it or not, they following after your path.
Teach it.
Read that again.
And ye, the flock, and ye, my flock, the flock of my pasture, are men.
The Most High God is very sure, very clear. The flock of his pasture are men. You
That's
men,
right.
You black men, you have to stand up. You
right.
Hispanic men, you got to stand up for God's laws.
That's right.
Not some gang that been made up in this life. Not for the GDs, not for the BDs, not for the vice lords, the four corner hustlers. No, you need to stand up for God's laws.
That's right.
Take heed to God's laws. Stop being weak. Stop wasting your time. Read the rest of that.
And I am your God, saith the Lord God.
Give me Jeremiah 14 and 2. My brother with the blue hat across the street. Come over here and rap with us real quick. Give us a call. Make sure you give us a call. Because you black men, you got to stand up. You got to stop doing what's wrong. You got to start keeping God's commandments. You got to start upholding God's holy Sabbath. You got to stop getting drunk. You got to be sober-minded. Get you a legit job, making legit money so that you can raise your community. Stop selling drugs.
That's right.
Because you're destroying your people. You are destroying your people. You're destroying your elders. Read.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 14 and verse 2.
Bring it out.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish.
So it says Judah mourneth. What it's talking about here is the tribes of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, which are the so-called blacks, the so-called West Indians, and the so-called Haitians. It says Judah mourneth. Judah mourneth, why? Because we are the heads of the nation of Israel.
Yes.
But it says Judah mourneth. Read.
And the gates thereof languish.
Says the gates thereof language. The gates is talking about the where the rulers of the cities are at.
Right
now in Chicago, ain't no leaders of the people. It don't matter if your alderman is black or your politicians are black men. If they not keeping God's laws, they are not in their right position. They're not doing what they supposed to be doing for our black community.
That's right.
They are in the midst of language. I want you to read this definition real quick. Read this definition of language. Because it says the gates thereof language. Read that. The gates thereof language. Let's see what the word language means.
languish, to lose strength or animation, to become dull, feeble, or spiritless, to pine, to be or grow heavy.
So let's read the scripture again, then we're going to go into that. Because it says to become dull. Read that again, Jeremiah 14:2.
Judah mourneth.
Hey, young men, come up here, stop for a minute. I know y'all got some time. Listen to this Bible come out. This Bible is your history book.
Right.
This Bible talks about us. It doesn't talk about this so-called white man right here on this sand. It talks about the truth. That black image of Christ that you see over there. This Bible is about you, young men. Read.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish.
So it says, Judah mourneth and the gates thereof languish. What it's talking about is the leaders of the black community. It says they languish. Now let's read that definition again. The leaders of the people, it says they languish. Read.
Languish. To lose strength or animation.
So it says to languish means to lose strength or animation. Because no matter how many black leaders that's in our community, what's going on in our communities? You still got young men being shot and killed. You still got babies being shot while they in their living room from a straight bullet. These things are going on. So that's why it says the gates thereof languish. The leaders of our people, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, they have lost animation. They have lost their life. Read.
To become dull, feeble, spiritless. To pine, to be or grow heavy.
So it says to become feeble. Our black men are weak.
That's right.
And what is that weak meaning? They're emotional. They live off their emotions because most of our black men were raised in a single parent household.
Right.
And that's not designed to be because if you young men, y'all can't learn to be men from a woman. And I don't know if y'all growing up in a single parent household, but you can't learn how to be a man by living under your mother. Only thing your mother's gonna be able to teach you is her emotions.
That's right.
She can tell you all she wants, she can say all she wants, but what you're gonna pick up is her actions and how she reacts to things.
Right.
And that's gonna be emotions. So what happens when you have a single parent household, a single mother raising men, they're gonna grow up and be moms. They're gonna grow up and be the gangbangers that's terrorizing the community. They're gonna grow up and be the ones that's shooting bullets randomly. You understand? So read that, start from the top.
Jeremiah chapter 14 and verse 2. Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black unto the ground, and the cry of Jerusalem is gone up.
So it says they are black unto the ground. Judah is black unto the ground. This has two meanings. It's talking about our skin complexion. Judah is black unto the ground. We are the tribe of Israel and the whole nation of Israel. We are a dark-skinned people. We have black skin. So this white image, y'all ever seen that white image that's here? Where y'all see it at? Church. That white image ain't got nothing to do with this Bible.
I'm
going to show y'all, young men, so y'all can see it.
Teach y'all.
But it says, read that again.
Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish.
So the leaders of the nation of Israel, it says they mourn it, and engage language, meaning the languishing is that they become feeble. They have become weak. They are walking around terrorizing the streets,
right,
shooting and killing and robbing. That's not how we're supposed to be, but right, that's how it is because we are in our captivity. We have turned away from God's laws, statutes, and commandments.
That's
so
right.
Now we are in languishment. Our men have become feeble. Our men are hanging in a park and hanging in parks and things like that in our communities, hanging on the streets, doing nothing all day. And then when something pop off, what they ready to pull out a gun and shoot and kill each other. That's not how we supposed
to. We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.